Well, I'd just like to say on our about to leave time that actually we've had a wonderful 2 days in Ohio, especially our visit to Cincinnati and to Columbus. And we felt that we've had a wonderful reception by the people and by the press, by all the TV and radio people. It's been a most interesting, most wonderful visit. I thought I'd brief you a little bit on what I've been up to recently so that you might know what I've been doing and maybe eliminate some questions and help you a little bit with the story. In the last few weeks, I've been very, very busy traveling, not only in the United States with my husband, but also on my own a good bit of the time. I traveled to Europe as a member of the President's Committee on Mental Retardation as a delegate to the International Congress on Mental Deficiency that was held at Montpellier, France. But before arriving there, I went to visit several facilities in Copenhagen, Denmark, along with two of the other delegates, one Dr. Kugel from Nebraska, and the other person was George Jones from Denver, Colorado. They're both members of the President's Committee. There were five of us as delegates to the committee, and of course we will make a report to the committee that will also go to the president. The president has taken personal interest in the field of mental retardation, very much the same as our former President Kennedy did. President Kennedy first appointed a president's panel on mental retardation, and President Johnson has continued this by appointing 21 people from the lay community as well as doctors and experts in various fields on the President's Committee on Mental Retardation. As you can see, this is a very deep involvement that I have, and I'm very pleased and thrilled to be a part of it. It gives me, I feel as though I have done, I'm doing something that is dearer to my heart than almost anything I've ever done. It's a result of the fact that we had the tragic circumstance in our family of having a little mongoloid child born to our daughter, her first baby, our first granddaughter, who is Vicky. She's not a tragedy anymore. She's a delightful little girl. We have overcome the tragic first news that a family feels when you find that you are suddenly faced with the very shattering fact of mental retardation in the family. So through her, I have learned, I understand what it means for people to have this in their family or as a part of their lives. And I've learned a great deal from Vicky. We all have learned a great deal from Vicky and about greater love and greater family affection, I think, than any other possible way. Other than that, after I got home from Europe, after working very hard and attending, not only just being an official wife visiting the Congress, I attended many of the sessions and learned a great deal. And then I was home for 2 days, and then joined Mrs. Johnson on a 7-state tour. I was with her for 3 days. She continued one more day. I don't see how she did it, but she did. She's a great trooper. And we were visiting the states in the Midwest, emphasizing many of the federal works that have come as a result of the administration and these congresses. And then I caught up with Humphrey, and I'm traveling with him. We'll go back home tonight and be in Minneapolis and Waverly this weekend. So that's been my life for the last 3 weeks.
Just General, we have a lot of women in our audience, and they're concerned about some member of their family, perhaps their husband, their son, their grandson in Vietnam. Do you have any comment, any word of encouragement for us?
Well, I'm concerned, too. I don't agree with all of the things we've been doing in Vietnam. I wish we would use the power that we have available to proceed with the war and get it over with. The policies that we have been pursuing have not led to the results that we want, and it has brought ever-increasing casualty list on both sides. I think we should use our strength and win the war and get the fighting over with.
Do you think, then, that sometimes we don't always get the truth about the war?
Well, I certainly think in many cases there's been a lack of information.
General, in Time magazine, they said that you might be interested in running for president. Is this true?
I'm not a candidate, no.
You're not a candidate.
Ever since I retired, received literally hundreds of letters from people all over the country suggesting that I run for the presidency or for the Senate or get into politics or do something. And I've always given about the same answer that we in the military are not interested in politics. We always considered it a nonpartisan issue, as a matter of fact. But just because you hang up your uniform, you don't forget the country. And if there's sufficient demand for me to serve the country again, certainly I would consider it. But I haven't seen that overwhelming demand as yet.
Good for you, General. General, I'd like to ask you about the Air Force. You were head of the Air Force until 1965. What big changes have you noticed?
Oh, about the same changes that you would see between the 1928 automobile and the 1965 automobile. Perhaps even greater because the technology in aeronautics, I think, has been moving faster than technology in motor transportation.
General, what have you been doing in your retirement?
Oh, I'm just as busy now as I was before I retired. I'm chairman of the board of a small electronics firm and vice chairman of the board of the Executive Jet Aviation, which is a small air operation that is operated by some of my ex-Strategic Air Command officers. I'm still on several other boards, including the National Geographic Foundation, trying to do some city chores out in Los Angeles. And as a matter of fact, there's so many things to do that I haven't been able to do the hunting and the fishing that I planned on doing when I moved to California.
You haven't been able to relax, is that it?
Well, I've relaxed to some extent because I don't feel that I have the heavy responsibilities that I used to have, but I haven't any free moments, let's put it that way.
General, let's get back to responsibilities again. What about Pearl Harbor? Do you think that could happen again to us?
Well, no, I don't think so. I think our radar defenses are better than they were then, although I don't think they're as good as they were, say, 5-7 years ago. We need more money spent on them. But we do have a better alert system and defense system than we had at Pearl Harbor.
Of course, you reorganized the Strategic Air Command, and we have a SAC base here that we're very proud of. Any comment on the SAC today?
Well, I'm sure it's better than it was when I was in SAC.
Well, I don't
know. Time marches on.
Time marches on.
I have a great deal of confidence in the people who were with me while I was in SAC that were coming along, and we have a fine group of leaders there, and they'll carry out their duties in a highly responsible manner, and I have a lot of faith in them.
General, you were honored, and I think I read in the National Geographic, in 20 lands, one of our most decorated generals. And, of course, you're a native of Columbus, Ohio, aren't you? Went to Ohio State?
Yes, I was born in Columbus and went to high school there. Went to Ohio State. I have a degree in civil engineering, which I've never used, by the way. I went directly into the Air Force.
What about your family now? You have a daughter, you were telling me.
I have a daughter, she's married to a doctor, and they are now in Lincoln, Nebraska.
General May, it certainly has been a privilege visiting with you. Thank you so very much.
Enjoyed it very much.
Great pleasure. Thank you.